Hello, thank you very much for having me. There it says, I'm Matoni, I work for the Lothian Council. I asked the people to come along and tell you a little bit about the piece of work that you do called citizens' like inspections. Just to set your expectations, I don't have nice drawings like this, Steve. Slides. Firstly, a couple of apologies. First of all, if you sense panic in my voice, it's because I turned up at 10:15 and realised I said clearly the wrong presentation. So I had to quickly make some changes to what's there. So if anything doesn't make any sense, that's why. And secondly, to my colleagues from Westerly here, probably reading the top article that says delivering better outcomes, and thinking we finished that about a year and a half ago, so because it's on the wrong slide, so but we'll get to that again. So citizen light inspections is something that Westerly launched about 6 years ago. And really it was designed as a programme to try to encourage members of the local community to get involved in redesigning and improving services. And we wanted to do that in a way that was a step away from the traditional customer survey and things like that, and actually engage with our customers on a much deeper level and get them really involved in how services work. There's a great thing in councils where customers have a perception of a service negatively or positively, but they don't necessarily have context around the service and how the service actually operates and some of the challenges that it faces. So what we wanted to do is invite members of the public, so people who live in West Lothian, into our place, to learn about how they work, and then tell us from a customer point of view, you know, the things that we do well or the things that we can do better. So we train our inspectors up. The framework around citizens' light inspections originally was based around what was a West Lothian assessment model at the time, which is like PSIF and EFQM. So we gave that was the framework around it, and we asked the inspectors to carry out an inspection based upon that framework. And as I say, it's very much about wanting it to be a positive experience both for the inspectors who are involved in it and for the services involved in it. So it wasn't just about people coming in and saying, here's all the things you do badly, here's all the things we don't like, here's all the things we want you to do better. But actually, here's the things that you do well as a service, and now that we understand that service a bit better, here's, you know, we have a better understanding of it, and therefore, you know, here's all the things that we think you do well, so that there's a positive bit there for the inspectors, but also a positive bit for services involved. So they don't just see it as another inspection or somebody coming in to tell them all the things that they're doing wrong or all the things that they should be doing differently. But actually, here's the things you do well as a service. So what we get out of it and the benefits for the inspectors as well is, as I say, as customers, the inspectors are all residents of Glasgow, they're all customers, so they're taking a lead role in how we're redesigning services, and I think particularly even more relevant now when we're talking about transformation and how services are going differently, it's actually getting customers involved in that. So rather than it just being a group of people who work for the council who think they know best, but actually what's the customer's perspective on it? What is it the customer actually wants from us? And rather than us thinking that we know what the answer to that is, let's ask them and have them involved in that redesign process and that improving process. And Kristen touched on it. That way of, you know, holding on to your wooden spoon, but, you know, we've all heard the council saying around all councils, no doubt, well, that's, we do that because that's just the way we've always done it. You know, but let's get people in who have a different view on that. So it's all about inclusion, it's all about engagement and getting people involved. You know, services able to utilise a low-cost resource, and unfortunately, West Lothian's old reserves have run out. So we have to go for the cheap option to get people involved. Our inspectors are all volunteers, they give up their own time. We do it out of a keen interest, first of all, when we're what we're trying to do, a keen interest in improving council services. So we don't pay them for it, we pay them, you know, their expenses, but they do it, as I say, with the goodness of their heart and as volunteers, which we really do appreciate, as I say, because it gives us that, their experience, it gives us their journey through our services. In terms of the inspectors themselves, they get a far better understanding of how councils work. As I say, they don't just have that outer perception of, you know, we'll sit around eating scones and drinking tea all day and not doing much work. They actually see what goes through, you know, the challenges they face. They understand things like legislation that maybe means that services have to do things in a certain way, and, you know, they're bound by that. But at the end of it, they see the result of the work that they've done because they see the improvements that come out of it. At the end of an inspection, the inspectors will do us a report, and in that report will be a list of recommendations that they make. From that, services will then develop an improvement plan, which is then presented to the inspection team. We follow that up, you know, 6 months, 12 months down the line, So inspectors get to see the results of the work that they've done. So they don't, it's not just a tick box exercise. They don't feel like they've dragged them in, used up their time and sent them away and done nothing with it. And you know, say, look at us, we're great, we're doing this wonderful thing. But we actually do use what they tell us. And services appreciate that as well, because they can then use that feedback to push through some of the things they want. I mean, there's a great, it looks great. A service goes to the chief exec, or they go to council executive and say, we'd like to make this change to the service. Oh, by the way, we've done a citizens' line inspection and they told us this. And it's great, you know, it carries weight, it carries evidence that possibly wouldn't be there before, but if we can say, you know, we've had the customers involved in it, they've told us this is what they want, they've told us that this would improve the service, and then it does get listened to. So this is the kind of general, kind of quick review of how the process works that we do. We select the team. Usually the team selects itself, because we ask the inspectors to volunteer. We usually look for about three to four people, and usually we don't get any more than that. Therefore the team selects itself, so that makes that bit quite easy. We'll bring them in, meet the service, get the, you know, a bit of background information about the service in that context, and we'll give them at that point, you know, some more information about the service, performance information, some of the context around the service, if there's legislative requirements, that kind of thing. The inspectors then plan what they want to do based on that, so who they want to meet with, what bits of the service they want to see. So if they're doing a full kind of service review, we've got one ongoing at the moment, a waste and recycling service, so they've met with the staff, they've met with the operatives, they've been out with the, you know, on the bin trucks, they've been to the community recycling centres, they've been to our new waste treatment plant. They've done all that, they plan all that themselves. We're there just to facilitate that, but ultimately we kind of give them free rein. You know, there's nothing hidden from them. They can look at budgets, they can go through procurement if they want, if they're interested in that type of thing, they can look at how we do all these kind of things, the governance side of it as well. We don't hold anything back from them, because we can, again, what we feel is we don't want to set this up too much for them so that we drive it in a certain way. We want to let them do it and do it for themselves. So they go through all that and that process, and at the end of that they'll write their report. And again, it's their report that they're writing, not us writing the report on their behalf. They're doing it, so it's their words. And they enjoy that, I think, because it gives them the freedom to say things that maybe if I was writing the report for them, I wouldn't be brave enough to say, but they can say it because, you know, they've got that freedom to do that. So they put the report in, the report to the service. The service will then develop an improvement plan on the back of that. And present that to the inspectors, or have that conversation where they say to the inspectors, actually, some of the things you've suggested we can't do because of X, Y, and Z reason, or here's the things that we are going to do, and here's how we're going to do them, and the time frame we're going to do them. And then we always follow that up with a review 6-12 months down the line again. Part of that being so that the inspectors know, I haven't forgotten about this, we didn't take all that, you know, all that work that you did, and, you know, forget about it and stick on a shelf and, as I say, tick a box and tell everybody we're brilliant because we've got this great thing and we do nothing with it. That whole process there, as we designed it, can take anything from 8 to 16 weeks, just depending on, you know, the size of the inspection that you're doing, the size of the service you're looking at. Also just some of the logistics, as I say, people are volunteering, so getting everybody in the same place at the same time can maybe take a couple of weeks if you've got three or four inspectors who want to meet with the head of service who's not available for 3 weeks, then, you know, all these things can take a little bit longer than we think. So that whole process, as I say, can maybe take 3 or 4 months, and then with the review bit at the end of it. So it is very intensive, it is very very full on, you know, for the inspector as well as the service as well. We've obviously got to buy in the process. That was how it started, and we've now tried to develop this as we go, because that can be a very intensive process for people. And some inspectors like it, they enjoy that, they have a background in that kind of work, so they enjoy getting that involved in it. Others don't. Others have been through that and say to us at the end of that, actually, you know, that's a lot of work and I don't want to give up that time, or actually a lot of that just went, you know, right over my head and I just didn't get it, I didn't understand it. So rather than lose people who, you know, came to us and said, we want to get involved, you know, we want to be part of this, and rather than, you know, lose that, we've tried to develop it as we've gone, so that actually we keep the people who want to do the full on stuff and get really involved in it and enjoy that. But actually those people who want to contribute but don't want to do that, we've moved on. So what we've developed in the last couple of years is something we call loop inspection. hate the term mystery shopper, but that's what that is. In many senses, it's, we ask our customers just to go in and experience the service, experience it live, experience it as any customer would. So it lends itself very much to kind of frontline services. So you know, go to the CRC site, you know, go in there, use the service. Was it easy? You know, was it easy to find? Was it easy to use when you get there? Did you understand all the things when you got there? You know, did you know what bit went where the wood went, where the plastic went, where the paper went? You know, could you find out information about that service on the council's website before you went? You know, its opening times, its location, that kind of thing. So it lends itself much more to, you know, the inspectors being able to do that in their own time. Or actually, you were going to the CRC site anyway, so go and do that for us. We do have a structure too. We do give them a template that gives them something to work off. But a lot of our inspectors really enjoy that process now and are very, very engaged with it because it's a little bit less intensive for it, but we still get quite a lot out of it at the end. We still get the improvements bit at the end of it. We still get the positive things because a lot of what comes back is very positive about services, but we get the improvements things in this. And because it's that live and the front facing, usually the improvements are very quick. They're very easy ones to do. You know, it could be something as simple as, well, you need a better sign up there. You know, actually, it tells us when this opens, or you know, that kind of thing. You need to update your website with better information, that kind of thing. Things that we can fix very easily. So that's one of the ones we've developed. The second thing on our track, we're now in the kind of stage of developing, is we want to increase the kind of demographic of the inspectors that we've got, because to be fair, the majority of them are a bit mature, if you like. A lot of them are retired, they've got the time, if you like. But what it gives us is it only gives us one perspective, if you like, of the services. So we're working at the moment with our colleagues in education to develop pupil-led inspections, to get pupils within the secondary school involved in some doing something very similar. Now that will probably start off as, you know, doing something that is, you know, council service that's directly related to the schools, or, you know, something that really interesting. But hopefully over time we can then start to bring some of these people into our kind of wider inspections and give us a different viewpoint on what's happening. We've also agreed a programme of inspections with the inspectors that meets their interests. So the big thing you have is, you know, inspectors want to do this, but as I say, they're giving up their own time. And they want to do it for something they're interested in, you know, and they want to do it for a service that they know that they maybe understand, you know, fine. See, this lends all of these types of inspectors to lend themselves better to kind of frontline services, the ones that people know about, you know, waste, roads, you know, customer service centres, that type of thing. We did one once where we did one in procurement, and it was all about procurement. That is not the most exciting thing for anybody to get involved in. And unfortunately, it scarred up two of our inspectors so much that it's taken them 3 years to get back involved now. So we learned a lot from that, you know, as much as it's good for us to get that input into those kind of internal services, the inspectors don't have an interest in it, they don't really, and a lot of it does, you know, go way over our head. So we've had that feedback from them about what services they would like to look at, so what interests them. And when we do that, we find that it's much easier to get people involved because they do, you know, straight away they know, and it's easier for them when they are involved because they understand already, you know, everybody knows how to get the bin emptied, and you know, it does give them a perception of the service before they start, so they've all either got a negative perception or they've never got a bin empty, so your service is rubbish. But actually what you find, a lot of them give us the feedback at the end is, I didn't realise that that's what you had to do. I didn't realise that was all the, you know, all the legislation you had to follow, all the hoops you had to jump through, all the challenges you faced on a day-to-day basis. I thought you just like emptied the bin. You know, how difficult can that be? But actually, there's a lot more that goes into it than that. So I think they like it from that point of view, and they get a better understanding of it. So we try to do that, as I say, get people involved in it, get their interests going. Coming to the kind of challenges, one of the big challenges we have is getting people, you know, involved in it and retaining the ones that we have, and see, not losing the mentally scarred ones who've been through procurement for 4 months. But how do we encourage more and more people to get involved in, as I mentioned earlier, expanding on that demographic so that we're getting a bit more insight from really from the younger generation about some of these things as well, and some of the particularly as we try and transform them as we're going forward. Keeping inspections within a scope and a reasonable time period is quite important, because sometimes inspectors get carried away with themselves and they want to kind of go and fix the world when they come in, and we have to sort of pull them back a little bit sometimes, and whilst letting them have the freedom to go and do it, but we do have to be there to some occasion to give a kind of guiding hand. But as I say, the reasonable time period as well is something that we always struggle with, because as much as I kind of always say at the start of this, okay, this 3 months, we'll have this finished by Christmas. You know, I had a meeting with the inspectors yesterday, they're doing the basement, and said, well, it'll be the end of January now. So, you know, we never quite get our time scales right. And despite at the end of every inspection saying, right, next time we need to make sure we've got, you know, we set our time scales a bit better than that, we never quite get there. And obviously encouraging the services to commit to it as well, because there is a commitment from them, depending on the type of inspection they're doing, the kind of look-see inspection is far less commitment for a service, and they only really need to get involved at the start and at the end. But the more full-on one, they have to, you know, they're involved throughout of it. But I think, as I say, as long as we can keep seeing the benefits out of it and getting those improvements back in that customer insight, that does help them. So that's kind of, I mean, that's a kind of whirlwind of what we do for our inspections. It is a positive thing. We do find that it works very well. It does bring its challenges, and it's been well received by any external inspection we've had. Best Value Audit praised it within last year, and they praised it, although they did say we need to do more of it, so that's kind of put pressure on us a little bit. Investors and People, Customer Service Excellence have all kind of given us very positive feedback on this as an approach. So I think that is something that we're very committed to, but as I say, it does bring us challenges. Kind of maintaining it and keeping it going through the years it's getting harder and harder, but as we run out of easy services for the inspectors want to get involved in. So we do have a challenge. So I'd be interested, you know, if anybody is doing anything similar or something like that, that, you know, we've got any good ideas about how we keep it going, and I'd be interested to hear that. Everything we do is all published. We publish it all on the council website, so you know, if you want to have a look at it, it's all there. If you go to the West Lothian Council website and put CLI into the search box, it will come up. We publish all the reports that come back from the inspectors as well. It's all there as well, so you can read all of them, and you can see the kind of output that we get from it, from that. So see, that's kind of it. I'll remember doing questions at the end, so you know, if you've got questions and if you want to catch me at any point throughout the day, do that, and I can tell you a bit more about it. Thank you very much.